Refraction is a difficult topic if understood without practicals. Welcome to Science Pedagogics, Science Made Easier. And our today's topic is refraction through glass slab. Before proceeding, I would like to thank you all for your support. And do like, share and subscribe this channel as your support matters a lot.
Hello students, children. Today's topic is light. The ultimate source of light is solar energy. It means that light is a form of energy. Second thing, we are able to see anything with the help of light. Means if we will stand in a dark room, then we are not able to see anything. It means light is essential to see any of the object. So let us start the topic with the definition of light. Light is a form of energy which enables us to see any object. There are various phenomena in our daily life which are related with the light. First, formation of our image in the mirror. Second, twinkling of stars. The formation of rainbow of having beautiful colors, as well as that when we keep our pencil inside a glass which is filled with water. अगर आप एक पेंसिल को ग्लास फिल्ड वाटर में रखोगे तो ये पेंसिल जो है वो हल्की सी बेंड हुई भी नजर आएगी. सो वॉट कुड बी द रीजन ऑफ ऑल दीज वन बिकॉज ऑल दीज फिनोमिनास आर रिलेटेड विद लाइट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द नेचर ऑफ लाइट. अगर हमें ये सब फिनोमिना एक्सप्लेन करने हैं, व्हाई शैडो इज फॉर्म्ड, हाउ वी आर एबल टू सी आवर इमेज, तो उसके लिए हमें सबसे पहले लाइट की नेचर को जानना जरूरी होता है. According to many of the scientists, light is made up of particles. Yes, children, we are not able to see these particles, but light is made up of particles. That shows the particle nature. For example, formation of image, formation of shadow, okay, and again bending of light, twinkling of stars, all these phenomena are related with पार्टिकल नेचर ऑफ लाइट. ये सभी एग्जाम्पल्स ये शो करते हैं कि लाइट जो है वो डिफरेंट पार्टिकल से बनी होती है. बट कैन यू एक्सप्लेन दैट वेन लाइट फॉल ऑन अ वेरी माइक्रोस्कोपिक ऑब्जेक्ट, अगर लाइट जो है वो एक बहुत ही छोटे ऑब्जेक्ट के ऊपर गिरती है तो लाइट उसकी साइड से बेंड हो जाती है. बट टिल नाउ वी हैव स्टडीड, अब तक हमने ये पढ़ा दैट लाइट ऑलवेज ट्रैवल इन स्ट्रेट लाइन. लाइट स्ट्रेट लाइन में ट्रैवल करती है, स्ट्रेट पाथ होता है, इट प्रोपागेट्स. बट हाउ इट बेंड्स, दैट प्रोसेस इज नोन एज डिफ्रेक्शन ऑफ लाइट. सो हाउ डिफ्रेक्शन ऑफ लाइट हैपेंस, मीन्स जब लाइट किसी भी एक स्मॉल पार्टिकल के ऊपर गिरती है, दैट इज वेरी माइक्रोस्कोपिक पार्टिकल, तो ये उसकी पार्टिकल की साइड से बेंड हो जाती है. सो हाउ इट कुड बी हैपन, ओके. सो इन दैट we can explain with the help of another nature of light, that is wave nature of light. Bending of light around the very small particle, that can be explained with the help of second nature of light, that is the wave nature of light. Now some of the examples explains that light is made up of particles, whereas some of the examples explains that light the wave theory of light. So whether these two are correct or which one is correct, to solve the problem, then the scientists introduced the another concept of light, that is quantum theory of light. Quantum theory of light explains that light has dual nature. It means in some of the examples, some of the phenomena can be explained with the help of particle nature of light, whereas diffraction of light, photoelectric effect, these can be explained by using the wave theory of light. So light is a form of energy which shows dual nature. Now this video, that is totally related with the particle nature of light, in this chapter or in this video, we will discuss about the one commonest example that explains the particle nature of light, refraction of light. What is refraction of light? Before starting this one, let us discuss some of the... When light falls over the different surfaces, it shows different behavior. For example, when it falls over a transparent medium? What happens when it falls over a highly polished surface, or we can say mirror, or any rough surface? So the first case in which we have a mirror, okay? When light falls over this mirror, what happens? That it will bounces back from this mirror, and the it results in the image formation in this mirror. This ray which is falling on the mirror, that is called as incident ray. Whereas the ray which bounces back, it is known as reflected ray. And what the process, the phenomena of light, that is reflection of light. That is reflection of light. The second one, if light falls over a transparent medium like glass, water, kerosene, oil, then what it happens? It would not reflect it. It will enter in the another medium. Okay. So let us understand that this is again incident ray. Okay. This is normal, that is perpendicular to the medium. Normal is always perpendicular to the medium, and it is an imaginary ray. Now this point is known as point of incidence, which separates two medium. So that is known as point of incidence. Clear? Because we are talking about the light, behavior of the light ray when it falls over a transparent medium. It means here we can consider it air, and this medium, that is, we can consider it as a glass or water or kerosene oil, that should be a transparent medium. So whether it will travel in the straight path, because till now we have learned that light always travel in a straight path. So according to our knowledge, this light ray will move to in the second medium also straightforward. But now this time, this light ray shows the different behavior. It may be bent towards the normal. Okay. In case of glass, that incident ray, it bends towards the normal. So how it happened and why it happened, what is the name of this phenomena? That phenomena is known as refraction of light. That is known as refraction of light. So what is refraction? That bending of light, when it enters from one medium to another medium, but both medium should be transparent and they should have the different optical density. So that phenomena is of light is known as refraction of light. So let us write the definition of refraction of light. Bending of light rays when it travels from one transparent medium to another transparent medium having different optical density. That is the definition of refraction of light. It means bending of light ray when it travels from one transparent medium to another transparent medium having different optical density. Now, what do you mean by optical density? We know that what is density? What is density? Density means mass upon volume. The formula of density is mass by volume. So if we consider the air, then in that case, the mass by volume is very less, means air is less denser than glass in comparison to glass. Why it happens? Because in air, particles are far away from each other. It is an example of gaseous medium, whereas the glass, that is an example of solid, in which particles are quite close to each other. These particles are compactly packed. So that is the definition of density. But here we are using the term that is optical density. Optical density is somehow different from the density. It is the capacity of any medium, or it is the property of any medium, so that it can reduce the speed of light. It can increase or it can reduce the speed of light, that is known as optical density. And we use the word optical, that is related with light, that is related with light. Okay, so optical density and density, these two are different terms. It is the property, optical density, it is the property of any medium which decides the speed of light. Because the speed of light in air, that we can assume it is 3 into 10 raised to the power 8 meter per second. But it is different, it is very less in case of glass. Why it is very less? Because its optical density is more. Because the optical density of glass is more than air. So the speed of light in the glass, that is very less in comparison to the speed of light in air. Or we can understand this concept with the help of very common example. For example, when you are moving on a road, okay, and there is no traffic, then you can easily walk in a straight path, okay. But if you want to move in a crowded place, then again and again you have to change your path. Your speed would automatically decreases. Whereas on a road, then you can easily walk with a very high speed, but you cannot do the same on a crowded area. So same thing happens, because in air the particles are quite away, so air, light can easily travel with this speed. But as soon as it enters in the glass, its speed decreases, and due to the decrease in the speed, it bends. Where it bends? It bends at the point of separation of two mediums. It bends on the point of separation of two mediums, and that point is known as point of incidence. And again, once it enters in glass, again it follows the straight path propagation. So that phenomena of light is shows as refraction of light. It is the bending of light when it travels from one transparent medium to another transparent medium having different optical densities. So children, I hope it is clear that what is optical density. If we talk about air, then we can say that air is optically rare medium. We can use the term that is optically rare medium. Okay. Now, glass, we can say that it is optically denser medium. That is optically denser medium. Now here children, we have discussed the phenomena, that is when light moves from air to glass, then it bends towards the normal. In this example, हमने क्या देखा कि जब light air से glass में enter करती है, तो ये अपने original path को leave करके normal की तरफ bend हो जाती है. But whether it happens in the another case, if it travel from glass to air, whether it will show the same behavior? No. Now in that case, what happens? So now we will discuss the two cases, that what happens when light travels from air to glass, and second one, what happens when light travels from glass to air. So here we will discuss both the cases and try to understand the nature of the light. So refraction of light, the case one, light travels from optically rare medium to denser medium. Okay, to denser medium. Denser means optically denser medium. So let us try to understand this case with the help of one example. Here we have glass. Here it is the medium air and this is the glass medium. Okay. Let us imagine that this is the incident ray which is falling from any torch light. Now this is imaginary normal which always be perpendicular to the surface. Okay. Because the light is traveling from air to glass, means rare to denser medium, then according to the law, it will bend towards the normal. So, it will bend towards the normal. Let us imagine in this way. So, what does it mean? That it will not follow this path, that is the actual path. Okay. And at the point of incidence, it will bend towards the normal. Now let us label the diagram. This ray is normal ray. This ray is known as incident ray. Okay. Don't forget to show the direction of these rays. This ray is known as refracted ray. Okay. Now this angle, the angle between incident ray and normal, that is known as angle of incidence. So we can show the angle of incidence by small I, and the angle between normal and refracted ray, that angle is known as angle of refraction. Now we can easily see that the angle I is more than angle R in this case. Means angle of incidence is greater than angle of refraction. Why? Because light ray travel from air to glass. It means the speed of light ray decreases. In this case, speed of light ray decreases. Is it clear? Now, the second case. What happens when light ray travel from denser to rare? Light ray travel from optically denser medium to rare medium. For example, it may be glass and air. It may be water and air, it may be kerosene or air, it may be petrol or alcohol, then air. Okay, so let us draw the diagram for the second case. This is again that separation line of two mediums. Now here we can consider the first is glass and second medium you can take as an air. So light is traveling from glass to air. Again, we have to draw one incident ray. This is normal, that is again perpendicular to the surface. What we observe that after refraction, means after this point of incidence, this light ray will move away from the normal. This light ray will move away from the normal. Actually, it has to follow this path, that was the original path. But because the change in the density of the medium, it leaves this path and it starts following the another path. It means this ray is known as incident ray. So this is the second case of refraction, that is refracted ray. Okay. This is normal. Next one is, this is angle of incidence and this one, mean the angle between normal and refracted ray, it is labeled as angle of refraction. This is point of incidence. Point of incidence, right? Now we can easily observe that in this case angle I is smaller than angle R. Angle I is smaller than angle R. It means speed of light increases in air medium. The refraction is due to the difference in the optical density of two mediums, and when light travels from denser to layer medium, its speed increases. Okay. Now these are the two conditions when the light ray is falling with some of the angle. Now the third condition that may be possible, that if what happens if light ray will fall perpendicular to the surface. If light ray will fall perpendicular to the surface, so let us draw the diagram for that one. Again, you can take any of the medium. If light ray will follow the path of the normal, then what we will observe? We will observe that there would be no deviation in the path of light ray. It means this is the incident ray which is following the path of normal, and it will move straight forward in the another medium also. So this is refracted ray. How it happens and why it happens? The reason is only that the speed of light is different in both the mediums. But in this case, the angle I is 0. Angle I is of 0 degree. So angle R would be of 0 degree also. There would be no deviation in the path of the light ray. So these are the three situations when we can easily observe that what happens when a light ray travels in two different transparent mediums having the different optical density. When it moves from rare to denser, then it bends towards the normal. What happens? Then it bends towards the normal. Okay. In the second case, when it moves from denser to rare, then it bends away from normal. And in the third case, if it is perpendicular, if incident ray is perpendicular, then there is no deviation in the path of the light rays. So these are the three effects of refraction of light in the path of the light rays due to the refraction. Okay children, now we will discuss the another one. For example, we have a piece of glass slab. So we will study the another effect of refraction, that is by using a glass slab. Glass slab is a transparent piece of glass that is rectangular in shape. It means it is a rectangular transparent glass. So let us start the another topic, that is refraction of light. Refraction of light by a glass slab that is rectangular in shape and it should be transparent. Okay. So let us start by drawing the diagram. This is a piece of glass slab. Okay. It has four corners, so we have to label these corners as A, B, C and D. Okay. Now let us imagine that this is the incident ray. Okay. That ray is falling on the surface of the upper surface of that glass slab. Now if we want to study the refraction of light ray, then we have to draw normal, that is perpendicular to the surface. Because as we can easily observe that light ray is traveling from air to glass. Air to glass. It means that light ray is traveling from rare to denser medium. Light ray is traveling from rare to denser medium. So it will move towards the normal. It will move towards the normal. It means after refraction, it will bend and it will follow this path. Okay. Otherwise, what should be its path? Its path should be in this way. Clear? This ray is known as refracted ray. This ray is known as refracted ray. For the better understanding, we need to label these ray P, Q. Q is the point of incidence, R. Okay, it can be labeled as R. Now, when this light ray reaches at the bottom surface of this glass slab, again, there is one more interface between the two mediums, and that is glass to air. Again it happened. It means now the light ray will travel from denser to rare medium, because air is an example of rare medium. So what happened? It will moves away from the normal. Away from the normal. Okay. Now how much amount of banding will take place, that will depend on the nature of the surfaces, that will depend on the optical density of surfaces, that will depend on the thickness of the surfaces. Okay. So again we have to draw one normal. So here it is normal for this surface. After refraction it will bend, means it will move away. So let us imagine that it would happen. Clear? Wait a minute. Now we can label it as a P, Q, R and S. Okay. Now labeling we can do separately. P and Q. It is incident ray. For better understanding the diagram, Q and R, that is refracted ray. That is refracted ray. R and S, it is emergent ray, because it is emerging from the glass slab. So we can label it as a emergent ray. Next thing, beta, if this medium would not be present, or just suppose that if refraction will not take place, then what would happen? This light ray would travel in this straight path if refraction would not be happened. Agar refraction nahi hota light ray ka, to us condition mein light ray jo hai wo ye wala path ko follow karti. Okay, but actually what happens, it shifts away from its actual path. So the distance between these two one, it is known as lateral displacement. This is known as lateral displacement of light ray. Is it clear? The shifting of light ray from its original path. Shifting of light ray from its original path is known as lateral displacement. And we have labeled all these one. Now, it's a time to label the angles of various which is present in this diagram, the angle between incident ray and normal. Okay, we can label it as a N, N dash, then A1 and A2, we can label it as a. So the angle between P, Q and N, that is angle of incidence. So what is angle I? That is angle of incidence, right? Now next one is the angle between normal and refracted ray, means N dash Q R. This is known as angle R. So angle R means angle of refraction, that is angle R. And next one at the end, A2RS, means the angle between emergent ray and normal is known as angle of emergence. That is known as angle of emergence, right? So with the help of this diagram, now I hope it is clear to you. that in this way, when we study the refraction of light by a glass slab, then there two times the refraction will take place. First, when the light ray enters from air to glass, then it will move towards the normal and the speed of light decreases. Okay. Second thing, when it moves from glass to air, it means when it moves from denser medium to rare medium, then it moves away from the normal. And the actual displacement means the shifting of the light ray from its original path. That is known as lateral displacement of light ray. That is known as lateral displacement of light ray. So I hope it is clear to you now.
Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. And इस चैप्टर से रिलेटेड और वीडियोस आपकी स्क्रीन पे शोन है एंड प्लीज कीप अपडेटेड विद योरसेल्फ अबाउट आवर फर्दर वीडियोस.